Do you spend more time than necessary mixing your songs? And are you displeased with the results? Keep on watching. After mixing a ton of songs for Norwegian underground rap artists, I've discovered a way to mix that vastly improves my speed using a simple template. And weird as it sounds, speeding up the process also makes for better quality in the end. And best of all, you can just pause this video right now, go to the description, download the template, it's subphotic.com/logic, download it, and keep watching. So here's the big problem. Mixing slowly will cause you to lose the big picture. You will focus and hone in on the details early on in the mix, especially early on in the mix, and you will lose the big picture. And when you do that, you lose sort of direction of where you want to go with your mixes. There are specifically three problems that I have identified when it comes to mixing slowly. And the first problem is this. Track naming, sequencing, and coloring. In order to get the best result the fastest way, what I do is I always export my sessions, whether it's in Logic or on the MPC or in Ableton Live or wherever I create music. I will export it as tracks and I will import them into Logic, where I always mix. And I will do so into a template. And for example, in this case, I pull up a template called the Subphotic Stock Plugins template. And from here, I can start the mixing session afresh. This speeds me up because I don't have to take into consideration all the plugins that's in the session already. As you can see in this example right here, I have some plugins going on. It's a sampler, there are some synths, and there are some processors already going on. I just want to start clean without anything on. So in this template you see here, I have a lot of tracks already, a lot of buses, a lot of synths, and it's really neatly set up. And you can see when you open it, I have accommodated for when you import a stereo file with the beat and vocal tracks, but you can just close and open as you please. Now, I don't have any vocal tracks here. I only have stems from a beat. One of them is a drum track, which is a complete drum track. There's one cymbal, there's a synth, and there's a bass. And then I can just drag them up and place them accordingly. And when I've done that, I've already have the sequence of the tracks. It's really neat. And then I can just mark everything and select color. And now they're colored. It's already set from the get-go. The track naming is already there. And then I can just delete everything that I don't need. Boom, done. And now I've set the mix up for success. Now here's the other problem that often occurs, and that's grouping and busing. If you look at this template right here, I have everything organized into groups and buses. They're all set up, ready to go. The drums, for example, they're automatically routed into the drum bus folder, routed into the beat folder, which again goes into the mix bus, which again goes into the master bus. So everything has its path that I always use in every mixing session. So whenever I need to fix something in the mix further down the line, maybe I mix for other people and they want some revisions, I can just go back. I know exactly where everything is because they are in the same place all the time. And this is also beneficial for you if you mix your own songs, because if you want to change something, you hear that something is lacking here or there, or you need to remove something or whatever, you can just go back and you know exactly where in the mixing session everything is. You use the very same procedure every time. And as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, you can always go to subphotic.com/logic and just download these templates that you can see here. There are 6 of them and they're specifically geared towards mixing. So go grab them now, it's free, subphotic.com/logic. Now the third problem, and this is really a time sucker, and that's the send effects and all the insert plugins. Basically, all the processing. So as you can see in this template right here, we have all the processing set up on all the channels. Although they're bypassed, I can just engage a plugin and then I can start tweaking right away. Instead of opening up the folders and finding the plugin and selecting the plugin and wondering about whether I should use this compressor or that compressor, everything is set up, laid out, ready to go. No choices needs to be made. I can just start tweaking right away. That's a real time saver. And the same goes for send effects. When you send your audio signal to a reverb, for example, you also need that reverb signal to be routed correctly. You don't want that to go to the stereo bus, for example, bypassing the mix bus. So when you start reading the mix bus with effects, you don't read the reverb and everything is a mess. So here it's really organized. You just send a send effect, send it to an aux. The aux is routed into a bus, which is called effects bus. The effects bus is routed into the mix bus and so on. It's all set, ready to go. And if you want to see these templates in action, click on this video right here, because here I use it as I mix a complete song from start to finish. Hope I see you there. Peace out.